Wearing a mask properly is one of the basic protective devices one can use to help prevent becoming sick from a viral illness with potential life consequences, like the deadly SARS outbreak in 2002 and the coronavirus outbreak in 2019. This is especially true for healthcare professionals who may come into regular contact with infected individuals. Keep in mind that spread not only occurs via the nose and mouth, but also the eyes. So it is important to also wear protective eyewear if you will be near someone with the virus for an extended period of time. And wash your hands frequently and regularly. The N95 mask is superior to a regular surgical mask because of its tight fit that filter out at least 95% of particles in the air, including small particle aerosols to large droplets. Surgical masks allow unfiltered air to enter from the sides. As such, regular surgical masks only protect from large droplets and does a better job of protecting others rather than yourself. However, a N95 mask works properly only when it is correctly fitted with an adequate seal to the face. Otherwise, it will work no better than a surgical mask. Facial hair should be removed as it may prevent a tight seal. Also, make sure it is the right size for your face. For example, an adult mask will not fit properly on a child. First, fully open the top and bottom panels of the mask, bending the nose piece around your finger at the center of the foam. The straps should separate when the panels are open. Make certain the bottom panel is unfolded and completely open. Place the respirator on your face so the foam rests on your nose and the bottom panel sits securely under your chin. Pull the top strap over your head and position it high on the back of your head above your ears. While holding the respirator firmly on your face, pull the bottom strap over your head and position it around the neck and below your ears. Make sure the straps are not twisted for increased comfort. Adjust for a comfortable fit by pulling the top panel toward the bridge of your nose and positioning the bottom panel under your chin. Place fingertips from both hands at the top of your nose and mold the nose piece around your nose to achieve a secure seal. Push inward while moving your fingers down the side of the nose piece. Always use two hands when molding the nose piece. Pinching the nose piece with one hand may result in improper fit and less effective mask performance. You know you have fitted the mask properly if it becomes noticeably more difficult to breathe in and out due to the increased airway resistance provided by the mask. This is normal and is supposed to happen. To further test proper fit, cup both hands over the respirator, covering it as much as possible and being careful not to disturb the position of the respirator. Inhale and exhale sharply. If air leaks around the nose, readjust the nose piece for a more secure seal and repeat the user seal check. It is imperative that there is no air leak, both on inhalation and exhalation, to ensure a tight seal to the face for the mask to work properly. If air leaks around the respirator edges, adjust the position on the face and the straps along the sides of the head. Repeat the seal check. To remove the mask properly, slowly lift the top strap from around your head while keeping the mask seated against your face. Do not touch the face piece, which may be contaminated with viruses trapped on the surface from use. Lift off the bottom strap. Carefully remove the respirator without allowing the outside of the mask to come in contact with your body. Dispose of the mask if it is damaged or contaminated with blood or body fluids. Wash your hands. There are other styles of N95 masks, including those with a valve as well as those that do not fold up. Regardless, they all work the same way. Undamaged and clean N95 masks can be reused, but keep in mind that viruses can remain alive and linger on a surface for up to 1 week, but can be inactivated by prolonged temperatures higher than 86 degrees Fahrenheit and/or disinfected with 62-71% ethanol, 0.5% hydrogen peroxide, or 0.1% bleach within a minute. Please keep in mind that the CDC does not recommend the routine use of respirators outside of workplace settings. Most often, spread of respiratory viruses from person to person happens among close contacts within 6 feet. The CDC recommends everyday preventive actions to prevent the spread of respiratory viruses, such as avoiding people who are sick, avoiding touching your eyes or nose, and covering your cough or sneeze with a tissue. People who are sick should stay home and not go into crowded public places or visit people in hospitals. Workers who are sick should follow CDC guidelines and stay home when they are sick.